got to eating all the good fruits and vegetables that they had down at the 4th Avenue Fresh Stop. And when I tasted the foods and started feeling how good they were to my body, I said, wow, you know, I'm from the West End. I would love to get this down into the Shawnee area, which is where I'm from. As a matter of fact, that's where we're set up at today, at Redeemer Lutheran Church in the Shawnee neighborhood.
I don't think that they have a lot of access to fresh fruits and vegetables that are affordable. Don't get me wrong, we have two big Kroger stores. We have a Save-A-Lot. You actually have grocery stores in the area, but it's very expensive. Fresh fruits and vegetables are very expensive. And then as far as the, what do they call it, organic? You can forget that. They're more expensive than the regular can. So I don't think it's a fact that we don't have it. It's the fact that what we do have, we cannot afford. And then if it's not an income thing, say for instance you have a family of four or five and they're getting $1,000 worth of food stamps a month. If you're not used to cooking like that, then you will opt out for the food that's, you know, might be fattening, not as starchy foods. You just don't. So I think the Fresh Stop is actually doing two things. It's allowing people to be able to afford the fruits and vegetables. Then we have the chef there on site, actually cooking those things to show you how. It's like educating them and allowing them to be able to participate in battles. I think it's just all, it's a really good program.
What I see is folks coming together and assigning responsibilities, but with always someone to help you. And then some of us call the farmers to see what they have, report back, talk about prices, talk about what we think the community would like. And then we place the order, and it's delivered. We all work hard to get it organized for distribution, and then we welcome the community to come and get the shares that they've invested.
The thing is that it's fresh vegetables straight from the farmer. You know,
not a lot of pesticides.
Not a lot of pesticides. Sometimes it's organic. You know, so you're not gonna go, you know, to Fresh Stop and say, oh, let me get 10 pounds of this and 5 pounds of that. You know, it's
what we have available to share you for that time.
Exactly. You know, what is available.
Yeah, so our goal is to help people reach their goals of health and wellness by providing access to fresh fruits and vegetables, leadership and development opportunities so that they themselves can be involved in rebuilding the food system so that it's just equitable and thriving.
Well, we come in and we learn about, like, what is a food desert? We come in and learn about different issues that are at hand in regards to food and even down to racism. How food in the urban communities is not as fresh or as plentiful, and yet we're still spending a lot more money for it than in other parts of the city. So to be able to come in and educate the community on those things gives them power, gives them integrity, gives them confidence to be able to stand up for their food rights. And that is part of the food justice program. And also, they also learn how to run a Fresh Stop. So that's some of what the food justice program is about. You know, we're our goal is to teach everything from the seed to manufacturing to distribution, to cooking, to gardening, the whole nine yards, and just educate. Education is really what food justice is all about, educating the community on the good and the bad.
And this year we have two new Fresh Stops. There's a third Fresh Stop that is on its own. So our goal is to eventually, all our Fresh Stops that we help to develop are working pretty much on their own and maybe in partnership with the other Fresh Stops, but that new Roots is moving on to organize other Fresh Stops, other new Fresh Stops. So our goal is to have five running all together next season, and hopefully to also recruit two more farmers to work with us.
It brings together a stereotyped community over something that is important to all of us, and that's food. and it raises our consciousness as we participate, and in turn, we turn around and influence those around us. So I think this is an excellent project to get us connected to even greater justice issues.
The issue of obesity in our city that I know everyone knows is very bad. We're in the top 10 for children and adults. And to me, that's something that is a crisis.
People are so in the habit of grabbing some fast food, and we're trying to teach people to eat healthier. And by being fresh, you're definitely not getting the processed food that you get when you grab the fast foods.
One of my goals of being here for right now is to create a base for the cooking classes that are coming up, and to also to be able to educate more people about eating more healthier like this, because I know down here in West Louisville, diabetes, high blood pressure, the statistics down here are very, very high. So hopefully if we can get enough folks to come in and start switching their eating habits, we can help fight, and eliminate some of that in this community.
And I'm cooking a grilled veggie salad. I toss it in extra virgin olive oil and some signature seasoning. After they're finished, I'm chopping them up real good, and I'm tossing them in some Swiss chard, fresh kale, and fresh mustard greens with a little shredded cabbage. And I'm going to top it with a little vinaigrette dressing.
You was asking us if it would help people learn the different produce that's available to them,
Yeah.
I think it's teaching people that there are different things out there that you can eat,
And there's
different ways to eat.
So how many people do you deliver to?
She's the only one today.
Yeah.
This is like four times more stuff than she had last time. So she's really a mummy now. Miss Nellie is her name. Miss Nellie. That's the head of cabbage.
Okay.
And then there's two cucumbers up under there.
Thank you.
These are your fruit. You get three peaches and four nectarines.
All right.
Now what is that? Kale. New potatoes.
All right,
let me
put me some green beans on it.
I'll be back over. You just let me know. Squash.
Yes. Alrighty, what is this? A red onion. Alrighty.
Green beans.
Oh, you got my green beans. From my new potato.
Yes. Oh, it sounds so good.
Yes, honey. It's just been a blessing to have this vegetable coming into us. And we enjoy it all. And I love to cook. And it's just great, nice, fresh vegetables. It's good for us. We just thank Dr. Krieger for telling us about it.
If anyone wants to get involved, all they have to do is you can come and visit us at our fresh stops, which are usually every second and fourth Thursday. This week we kind of push it up because of the 5 weeks in June and the 5 weeks in July. But August we'll be going back to our second and fourth Thursday of each month. And they can come down here and sign up as a volunteer. They can call me, Nathaniel, at 509-8836. I have no problem giving out my phone number as long as you call in to be a volunteer at the Fresh Stop, and you can also order shares with me as well. You can also come down to the Redeemer Lutheran Church, and you can just let them know you want to volunteer for the program. And you can also let them know at the Shawnee Arts and Culture Center, which is right down the street from the church. Portia Muhammad will be able to help you with that. She can sign you up as a volunteer or as a shareholder as well.